moving swiftly along here this morning, as my featured guest this morning is talented actress. She is director, chief cook and bottle washer in the local arts and theatre industry. I am so happy to have once again on the show, Penelope Spencer is with me this morning.
Thank you for having me.
So glad to have you back.
Yes, it's been wonderful to be here again.
You look lovely, you look gorgeous.
Thank you. I try.
How you woke up this morning?
Yes. Yes, this is how I get up every morning. This is a lovely set.
Yeah, very nice. First time you're actually here.
This set, in the original. It's good. How have you been going?
I've been good.
You are chief cook and bottle washer yourself. Nice.
I do a little bit of
everything.
Of everything.
Literally. Nice.
So, I know you are so very, very busy.
Yes.
Man Talk is your latest project.
Yes. Man Talk is happening at Napa this Saturday, today, Saturday at 5:30 p.m. So it's not the usual regular 8:30 theater time.
Right.
You know, they're trying to get as many people as possible to come into the theater, and we are aware of the crime situation, so we want to get people home, back to their homes early. So we went to 5:30 at Napa this for this production, Man Talk.
Right. And so it's one show.
One show only.
Because normally when they do the 5:30, you all do
8:30, but no, not this time. Not this time. This is definitely one show, 5:30 Napa, and this is a production by the SMRJ Foundation. It's not the regular Raghuwar Singh or Raymond.
This is the SMRJ.
Yes, Foundation. This is a foundation that works with at-risk youth in Trinidad, and mainly boys. And they're working with the Nelson Street area, Nelson Street school boys, the primary school, the girls school. They're working with the people in the area to help develop and empower them. And they usually have fundraisers to do this. You know, they've been doing it for, this is the third year that they've been working to empower our youths. And it's a whole project about caring for the people. And when you come to the show, you are also helping youths of Trinidad and Tobago and that Nelson Street area, you know. So it's a really wonderful project to be a part of.
So you're contributing back to the
giving back to the society, giving back to Trinidad. You know, we the actors and the whole cast and the crew, we've docked our usual salary, you know, because we all want to be able to help and with the process that they're going through with the youths. You know, the workshops, the classes, the, you know.
Excellent.
So we all wanted to do our part.
Excellent. So Man Talk almost seems very familiar in that there was, you're not involved, obviously, you're directing.
Yes, I'm just directing.
You're just directing.
Yeah.
But so in other words, take me through the process of what it's about.
Okay. What the play is about. Let me start from the beginning. I was in minding my business, and Dr. Oti, who is from the SMRJ Foundation, brought this play to me, Man Talk. Now, Man Talk was done in Trinidad about two times before. Earl Warner is the writer. Earl Warner, he's passed now. But I met Earl Warner when I was doing Wine of Astonishment. He was the director for that play. And I was so in awe of this man. You know, I thought he was a great director. And then I heard that he wrote the script, you know, so I had not seen the two past productions. I know Mervyn de Grouge directed one, and Earl himself came and he did one. And so all I knew was about men, and I never saw it. But then they brought SMRJ, Dr. Oti brought this play to me, and I was so intimidated at first, you know, because it's such a brilliant piece of work. What we're doing actually is an excerpt of it, you know. It's a brilliant piece of work, and it's talking about all these different problems that men go through in their lives, you know, and they talk about from old men to young men, you know, there's a variety of characters in this story, and they're addressing different issues like men and the law, and where the law is it for the men, like single fathers and all of that kind of thing. They have a scene addressing that. We have a scene talking about mothers and sons, you know, and how guys, men feel about their mother. They're talking about exposing their feelings and their fears and their, you know, their wants for their relationship with their mother. We have a scene talking about child molesting, you know. There's a guy doing a monologue about child molesting and where it came from and why he feels this need to do that. We have all kind of scenes. We have boys on the block. We have father and son. We have all kind of different scenes.
So this
scenes.
Is not just hysterical comedy.
No,
this
it's not necessarily.
This is real life stories as
real,
well.
Real life stories to a certain extent, because I know there was a lot of research done in Jamaica, because Ail Warner is from Jamaica, originally from Jamaica.
Right.
And he wanted a Caribbean perspective on men, you know, not necessarily a Trinidadian or Jamaican or a Bajan perspective. He tried to give a Caribbean man an all-round look at the Caribbean man, and you know, and what they stand for. So it's it gets the whole regional Caribbean
Penelope,
stories.
Penelope, when the reality, when you get forums like this artistically to express those things, it's great, because men, we don't speak like that about, especially some of the topics that you talk about. Yeah, we deal with it.
Exactly.
Men deal with it, and some men deal with it better than others, but don't really get the opportunity to speak
voice,
about it, a voice, and even hear it voice. Some men you hear it and you say,
and that's what we want to do, because even though the plays are serious, but it's very funny as well. Because I always think that the way you could capture people and get their attention is if you have a little comedy in it. They tend to listen, you know, more. Yeah. So, so it is a wide range of topics that men in the audience, even women, can relate to and identify as, oh, you know, that is me. And because women talk about it. That is you, and that is you up there talking. He talking for you. You know, so it's a play where you could really see yourself and hear how men, some could be ignorant, some could be talking real facts, you know, and everybody in the audience from 16 years and over, right, preferably, because there's some of the issues are adult, you know, in the way where the conversation happens. So it is really A wide range of things.
Excellent.
People could always identify.
Man talk, guys. Happening, as you say, this evening out at Napa. If you're not doing anything, Claire Shelley, this evening, go on down and support. In conjunction with the
Essimaji
Foundation. Really, so this foundation contributing to the Nelson Street community and developing that community. And that's so, so important. So you actually said contributing to some development of our youth in our society.
Yes.
This lady is directing it, and she is said a talent that I have adored over the years, and I'm always so happy to be in her presence. So I am taking her into the kitchen this morning, and I'm whipping up just a little salad for her this morning.
Nice. Yeah, I have a salad body. After carnival, I'm trying to get my salad.
I am trying to get back my salad body.
So
I'm staying away from meat and for a little bit.
Nice.
And I'm trying to get back my salad body.
Very good.
So that's what we're doing this morning. Come on back, we roll out a recipe next. I have Penelope Spencer with me this morning, and we're just climbing, having some fun.